you're all welcome to our end of year assembly this morning. So to start us off this morning, we'd like to call on our students to come up with our entrance song to our assembly here this morning. So if you could come up on stage, there were all, please. For a moment, thank you. Going back in the the roads of thoughts reading in the years. I think it's really appropriate for this class of 2018 that we say farewell to today. As I said, you will be leaving St Dominic's this summer, and so will Mrs Daly. And as I said at my retirement celebration back in May the 10th, I feel that the time is right to step down as my role as principal here. But I assure you and assure everyone here in St Dominic's that I will continue to be involved in the local services in Ballyferrin to ensure that our young people are supported, and I will certainly follow the great success of this school into the future. As far as cards in the OR, I know this has been ingrained in 6 years in the Ron Gaelic, but this is very, very close to my heart. I got that little card on that afternoon of May the 10th, and I think it's something that's very, very close to all of our hearts here in St Dominic's. Many friendships have been made, and I can certainly say that there isn't another school in this country that we as a staff and as a school community continues to strive to ensure that we have a happy environment here in our school. And that's the most important thing that we do as educators and as young people as we come here to school every day. We're one big family, and that's how it was described in a local supplement that we prepared for distribution with the Echo newspaper here in Ballyfermot a few months ago. We look out for each other, we care for each other, and that's what makes St Dominic's different, and that's what makes our school special. And I think this is the memories that these young girls will take with you as you leave next August. But very importantly for you as the junior members of the school and our fifth years, that you remember that we are a school that we care for each other, both staff and students. And I always believe that education is about conversations and relationships. It's at the heart of everything that we do. And I can honestly say that those conversations and relationships are at the core of everything that we do in St Dominic's in true Dominican style. Just a few words about these young ladies. They've been members of our school community since 2012, and it's hard to believe that it's way back in 2012 that we started this journey, and we reeled in those six years together with your tutors. We as a school community would like to thank you for your commitment to the school, and I know that everyone knows that they're Mrs. Daly's babies, you know, so nobody can ever say anything wrong about the 6 years right through there since their first year. But I'm so proud of your achievements. You've challenged me, I have challenged you, and together we have made a difference. And I am confident that the nurturing and the care that you've received will ensure that you'll have a really, really successful future, which I will follow closely in my days when I leave St Dominic's. Thank you for being you. May this day be a reflection of all the recognition you deserve, all the determination that lights your path, and all the wisdom that guides your steps. I will come back to you later. So, and a few more scales later on. So during our assembly here this morning, we're going to honour and acknowledge all the great work that is done in other year groups, and we will have awards for different classes and different year groups. We will announce our new leadership team, so I'm sure some of the fifth years are waiting anxiously to see who are getting the lead positions in our school next year in 2018-19. And this morning I would like to welcome Joan Crawford from the HSE, who will present us with our HPS, our Health Promoting Schools flag. And I'm delighted that Joan comes from a little place in Donegal called Castlefend, and that's where Mary Gallen was born. So it's a small world. Joan is from the same place as myself. So Tough Falcher Road, Joan, you're very welcome here this morning. And I'd also like to welcome Sister Liz back from her. She's on her healthies again, is she? Here this morning to share our assembly with us. As a leading DESH school, and you know that DESH is very close to my heart, we are really proud of our achievements, and the 6 years I know are proud of their achievements so far, and they have another big hurdle to get over in June, which I know they will be successful. I would ask you all just to stop for a moment and just think of something special that stood out in the past few months as students, something that you've felt proud of, something that you look back on with great pride, something that you've achieved, and to think of next year, what will I do and what will I do differently? The success of this school is due to everyone working together. Unity is strengthened. We all work together to ensure that we have a successful education establishment here in Ballyfermot. And thanks to all the staff, to all our teachers, to the SNA team, to our school completion team, to NBSS, and to our homeschool liaison. All of us worked closely. And as a school, we're unique in all of the partnerships that we have with local community groups and business partnerships with Ballyfermot Youth Service, where many of you are involved in, I hope will continue to be involved in during the summer, the Equine Centre, Candle, Family Scope, and then our business in the community partnerships, Allianz, DPS and Salesforce. And last but not least, I'd like to say Mila Buecas to the Dominican Sisters who have continually supported us in the years in providing extra supports for our students. And all of you know that when you want to do extra courses and extra trips to the Gaeltacht and other areas, that we have a Dominican Fund which supports you and helps you to be able to access these extra supports. So on that note, I'd like to call on Chloe Powell, our head mentor, to read a prayer of appreciation, please.
At the end of this school year, we give thanks to God for all the teaching and learning that has taken place in our school, both in and out of the classrooms, for the talents and the gifts that have been shared and challenges that have been faced, for the burdens that have been lifted and hurts that have been healed, for the respect and care that has been given. We give thanks for the friendships that have begun and for those that have grown, for the faith that has been lived in our daily struggles, for the hope that has been lifted our hearts on dark days, and for the love that keeps us going. We give thanks to our community that we are, and we ask you, Lord, bless our students as they sit our exams. Bless, may your spirit inspire them with confidence and calmness. Bless our families as we take our holidays. May our time together leave us with memories to cherish. Pour out your love on us, that we may return renewed and refreshed to continue our journey together. May we make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen.
So, Gura Margaret, Chloe, thank you very much. Very pertinent words to say. Thank you for all we have received this year. Now we move on to our awards ceremony, and we're going to start with our first years, and I'd like to congratulate our first years and second years. Last night we had a wonderful evening of celebration where the young ladies made presentations and shared with us many of the wonderful experiences and learning outside of the classroom and inside of the classroom that they have participated in the last year. So I say well done to the first year team, to Miss Green and her tutors, to Mr. Tracy and Miss Lawless, and to the second year team, Miss Kelly, Miss McMahon and Miss Keane. So well done to Gupton, who support our first and second years. So I'd like to call on Miss Green to present our first year awards, please.
Good morning, everyone. I've called up the two first year tutors as well to present the awards. Thank you. And on behalf of the first year team, we'd just like to extend our thanks to all the teachers who have worked so hard to ensure our first years have had a pleasant experience in the first year in St. Dominic's, the first of many pleasant years ahead to come, should I say. Okay. For one Tory, the sports award goes to Ellie Mae Dutton. Girls, we'll do a big clap for everyone at the end, okay? And you might, do you want to take a photo? Mr. Brian will do a photo. The attendance, Alicia Kelly. Happy end, thank you. The teamwork award for Ellen Purcell. And David Simpson. The award for consistent effort for Carmela Murray. The award for most improved student, the tutor award for most improved student for Molly Dunn. The award for punctuality for Leona Egan, and also to Emma Savage. Oh, apologies. The Tutor Award for One Tory is going to Sarah Louise Green. It's a great name. And the Student of the Year Award goes to Natasha Kerrigan. So well done. Goes to Sarah Tracy and Amy Mooney. The award for Most Improved Student goes to Leona Egan. And the Tutor Award for Most Cooperative Student goes to Ellen Purcell. Award goes to Tori Kinsler.
Okay, so well done to our first years, and I'd like to congratulate our first year one Aaron, who traveled to RDS last Friday, and they participated in the Irish Philosophy Awards, and well done to those students in UCD. They got a mention and a photograph in the Irish Times, so well done to Gupton, and also to one Tory who participated in the podcasting workshop on Monday afternoon. And as I said to you last night, that we're hoping to plan some activities. I know you'd love to hear this in June for you, because 3 months is a long time out of school, and maybe it gets very lonely for all of us. So we're going to plan some little activities with you in partnership with Ballyfermot Partnership. And I think Miss Daly is going to have a rugby camp in the first week of July. So lots and lots of fun planned for you. And also with school completion, their summer camp, and also other organisations throughout Ballyfermot will have their summer camp. So please, 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 as I always say, keep busy. Very, very important. We move on to our second years. I'd like to call Miss Kelly and her team here this evening to present the awards, please.
Good morning, everybody. Again, I'd like to wish the third years all the best for the junior cert, particularly the class I've taught. And definitely the sixth years, my best wishes. I've taught a lot of you since first year. And I was just thinking of a quote from Sir Alex Ferguson, of all people. I know he's been ill recently. And one of his famous quotes was, "Determination separates people." So I think you all have that determination, anyone I've taught. So maintain it, and it will make a difference, and work hard. Okay. My second year is, again, I don't work alone. Nobody does. So I'd like to thank particularly Mrs. Daly and Ms. Green for all their support, and my team, my tutors, Ms. McMahon and Ms. Keane, and all staff, just the whole school community. We all work together, and no woman, no man is an island, okay? So. To Dominic, and sorry, the SNAs, Lisa and Ashley. And for punctuality in To Dominic, Katie Klein. And Neve Byrne Sports, Chris Bailey Sports, and Disney Donnelly Sports. So that's important, girls. Maintain your sport, your activity. Recently this morning on the news, they're saying projecting in 2045 a quarter of the world's population will be obese. So maintain that activity in sport. So that's not a good statistic. And teamwork, Soraya. Shh, sorry girls, silence for you. teamwork Katie Byrne and teamwork Rebecca Doyle. Katie Klein, student of the year. Chloe Casey, most improved. Alicia Carney, consistent effort. And Daniela Holti, consistent effort. Tutor Ward, Serena, and Grace for attendance. Teamwork, Jodie O'Keefe, teamwork, Kira McKenna, consistent effort, Megan Fitzgerald, attendance, Michaela, sports, but you know. Megan Fitzgerald, punctuality. Tutor Ward, Maya. And a student of the year, Megan. Thanks everyone, thank you.
Okay, so well done to the second years, and we wish them all the best next year in preparation for their junior cert. We move on to third years now, please, and I'd like to congratulate all the third years who were involved in a most successful JCSP celebration on Tuesday evening, Junior Cert Schools Programme celebration. It was a wonderful evening, and as we say, it's an evening to celebrate all the wonderful experiences, activities, learning, both inside the classroom and outside the classroom, that you have been involved in over the last 3 years. And it's a night of celebration in preparation for your junior cert. We wish you all the best when we start our junior cert on the 6th of June. And I'd really like to thank our JCSP coordinators, Miss Cahill and Miss Sweeney, and I'd really like to thank Miss Sweeney, who's responsible for third years this year, for preparing the wonderful certificates, the profiles, your statements of learning, and looking at all the positive aspects and areas that you've been involved in our school over the past 3 years, and the wonderful video that Miss Sweeney put together, that a lot of people went for the refreshments. They were so good, Bernie. And didn't see a lot of the video, but a wonderful capturing all of the wonderful activities you were involved in. So a big vote of applause to Miss Sweeney, please. I'd like to call Miss Sweeney again. I think she's nothing else to do. It's third year head, and her third year team of tutors. We have Miss Brennan, Miss Tarpey, and Miss Pender, please. Okay, and can we all just clap at the end, please? Okay, for a mug, thank you.
So we'll start with Three Clark, but I suppose at this stage, just to recognise the girls, wish you the very, very best of luck as you go into your exams. And you have block classes next week, so time for some good revision and to really, really take example from the sixth years and really put in the hard work now in the last 2 weeks in the run-up to your exams, okay? And to thank, of course, the third-year team. I don't think I thank the first-year team, so sorry, Mr. Tracy and Ms. Lowe's. Thank you, and again, all the teachers who have worked so hard for you and given you so many opportunities. Okay, so for Three Clark, the award for attendance goes to Sarah McAvoy. Sarah only missed one day of third year, so well done, Sarah. Punctuality to Megan Cavanagh-Byrne. The award for consistent effort goes to Sophie Scully. and also to Nicole Hyland. So awards for always trying your best. The sports award goes to Shakira Donoghue for her rugby prowess. The teamwork award goes to Nicole McNevin. The most improved student is being awarded to Sophie Yulden. There is an attendance award, sorry, it's a second one for Lauren Hogan, who I know has missed no days in third year. So perfect attendance. The tutor award for the most cooperative student is awarded to Katie Walsh. And the student of the year for Three Clark goes to Sarah McAvoy.
Accompanying the girls to a wonderful trip to the west of Ireland, to the Burren and to Inishere. So we had great fun with the students, and again it shows how much that we care for our students and we spend time with our students, and these are the memories that these girls will take with them. We move on to fifth year now, and I'd like to call on Mr. Breen and his team, Mr. O'Brien, Miss Dunphy and Miss Lernahan to come forward, please.
Okay, thanks, Mrs. Daly. Just before we start, the fifth years, I want to wish the best of luck to the sixth years and third years in their exams. Luck is just a thing, girls, you know, it's the thing we say. It's hard work, and it's a calm head going into those exams is the important things. All right, done the hard work, just keep it going. Okay. All right, so we're going to start the fifth year. So next year we'll be sitting there in tan and corners as well. That's what you have to live up to, girls. Okay, so we'll start with Aquinas. The award for consistent effort goes to Amy Smith. Tutor award, Siobhan Lennon. Most improved students, Sarah McDonald. Sports award goes to Siobhan Lennon as well. Attendance award for Megan Doyle. Attendance again for Siobhan Lennon. Teamwork award goes to Katie O'Hanlon and to Lauren Osborne. And two awards here for Alana Rourke is attendance and student of the year. Sienna. Consistent effort, Laura Collins. A teamwork award goes to Lynn Carey, Sarah Bellamy. The attendance goes to Lauren Elliott, Montserrat Kadiri, and Chloe Kavanagh, and Lynn Carey. Well done, girls. Sports award goes to Sinead Nolan. Most improved student, a very much deserved, Rowan O'Horn. The tutor award goes to Montserrat as well. And student of the year, she's already up here, is Lynn Carey. Okay, Foy Martin. Our most improved student is Jasmine King. Consistent effort is Davina O'Driscoll. Attendance award for Lauren Reardon. Sports award for Lauren Reardon. And student of the year, Lauren Reardon. I'd just like to say a big thank you to the tutors as well. Sorry for forgetting you there to start.
Okay, so well done to our fifth year students and the fifth year team. To say well done this year, you've been involved in lots of activities and supports with your mentoring with UCD, with DPS and with Allianz. So keep up the good work and best of luck in sixth year. And I heard that you had a very successful trip to the Borgosh Theatre yesterday, so well done to Gafdina. Now we're moving on to our health promoting schools, and we're going to invite our team here this morning to come up and present to you the work that they've been doing over the last few years, and we're delighted that we're going to be awarded with the health promoting schools flag. So it's another first for St Dominic's, so well done to Gafdina. And I'd really like to say a big thank you to Ashley McKee and her team for pursuing this work and leading the committees in the work of the health promoting schools. So well done to Ashley. So good applause for Ashley. As I say, they just do it, and their proactive approach has made a huge difference to our school community. So I'd like to call on Aoife now to come up, please, and share with us the work, great work they've been doing.
Good morning. My name is Aoife Craig and I'm a transitioning student. I've been a member of the Help Promoting Skills team since first year. The Help Promoting Skills team is made up of staff, students and parents. We discussed mental health and physical health and healthy eating and how does these interlink and affect our health and our daily life. At the beginning of the process, we carried out a survey of staff, students and parents and devised an action plan based on the results of this survey. Some of the activities that we have carried out in our school community are the development of our sensory realm, handing out quotes, funky food and positive mental health happy Fridays, meditation on reading.com, improved lunches in the canteen, and early morning positive mental health happy walks, such as darkness into light and wearing ribbon to name a few. I enjoy being part of the Health Promotion Skills team because it makes me more aware of mental health and wellbeing and how we can learn to manage our overall health. Something I feel strongly about is promoting that everyone has mental health, and Health Promotion Skills team has carried out activities where this has become an everyday topic of conversation. And we have worked on breaking the stigma around mental health and promoting positive mental health in everyday life. My involvement in the Health Promotion Skills team has built STEM has had a positive impact on me personally, and I have grown as a person. I've gained confidence by pushing myself from my comfort zone, for example, having fun with my friends and public speaking. We are delighted to be receiving the Health Promotion Skills Award today from the HSE for the work we've carried out on improving health and wellbeing in our school over the past few years. We look forward to continuing the Health Promotion Skills team journey and will continue to strive for a happier, healthier school community. We will also be looking for members this September. Please feel free to join the Health Promotion Skills. All welcome. Lauren will now play a short video on some of the activities that we've carried out.
A bit close to home, I think. So I asked the vice principal during the day, and she filmed me. And I says, "Where's Joanne from?" So it turns out, anyway, from the tiny wee village up in Donegal, Castlefin. So sure, I was smitten with St. Dominic's from the start. Then, so congratulations to Mary on a great job. for the short time that I've been involved with the school, it's very evident the impression she has made on the place and the inclusiveness from top to bottom. So the very best luck in her retirement, and she'll have me crying her next. and I'm not here to the school, but it is an emotional day for y'all. I'm sitting here looking over the review of your health promoting schools today, and the person who works with the school, they're not supposed to review the school because it's supposed to be neutral and honest. So we gave it to another colleague, and I'll just read the last lines, and you'll know we're not lying. So she commended, congratulations to everyone involved in the process in St. Dominic's Community College on your absolutely outstanding achievements. This is truly inspirational portfolio of work, and I'm delighted to be able to confirm you'll be awarded your flag. The coordinator, Ashley McKee, has demonstrated a real understanding of the HPS process and an infectious enthusiasm that appears to have shone throughout the HPS team and the entire school to create a cultural shift. So inspirational and infectious. If any of us got that on a certificate, I'd like to have that one on my wall. So well done, Ashlyn, because definitely very well. Of course, school health promoting school is never successful fully unless we have the help of the students and the staff and the parents indeed, and the nuns that have set this wonderful school up, and at every juncture that I've been involved, you always invite them back, and it truly is a very inclusive school as far as I can see. And that's in essence what a health promoting school is about. And one of the earlier teachers talked about no man or woman is an island, and there's no I in team. So of course, when you work together, you can move mountains, and that's what the health promoting school is all about. So well done to staff, parents, and the committees as well. Now I want to tell you about a time when I was your age, sitting down there in St. Columbus College, Stranorder in Donegal. I was the head girl at the time, and they used to pull me out to do the public speaking, and if ever anybody failed at something, I was the best candidate for failing at public speaking. There were 1,200 students sitting in front of me, and I made a big boo-boo. I just couldn't do the speech on the day. But you know what? I have a colleague in the HSE, and she works in mental health, and she always says, do you know what, Joan? What were you worried about this time last year? And next week, what were you worried about a week ago? So, do you know what? We always get over the issues, and it might seem like a big thing now, but down the line it'll be grand. And I know this school are really focused on mental health and positive well-being. So for the seniors here that are, you know, coming into exam time on the junior cert, this time next year, what will you be worrying about? So don't get too worried about it. Just do your best, and it'll all work out for the best in the end up. For those of you that didn't get awards today, I've been here in this audience and I have seen and heard the beautiful music, and of course the girls here today set the standard as well, but there's arts and craft, there's music, there's sport, there's all sorts of things that we can involve ourselves in, and there's something that everybody is good at and strong at. And a health promoting school is about tapping into everybody's achievements and skills and talents and making the best job together, and this school does that in abundance. I know in mental health you've worked with Save Change, you've worked with the Green Ribbon, I see people wearing it today, you're working on health promoting school, you've worked with Headstrong, you did Cycle Against Suicide, you were out doing the Darkness Into Light with Phoenix Park, All of those things are marvellous. Your healthy eating is tied into mental health and physical health. You did workshops on physiology. You had healthy eating displays, fats and sugar displays. You linked it into your physical activity where you did a walk and track. You did exercise classes. Look, you've done so, so much. And that's down to this lassie in the front row again. There's lots of schools get a flag for doing maybe a fifth of what you've done. So you have done over and above, so much so that we've asked this school to be involved in the wellbeing review where my boss is coming out to meet you tomorrow, and she's going to use your school in her thesis. So, you know, not every school gets picked for that too, so well done indeed. And my last claim to fame was Brezzy. I taught Brezzy, would you believe that? I'm showing my age now. I taught Brezzy down in Mullingar, the CBS in Mullingar. And in all the time I taught him from first to third year, I never once spotted any of his little gremlins that he talks about now in his book. He calls it Jeffrey, doesn't he, I think?
Yep.
And I would like to think that I'm very astute and that I would have, you know, been able to, the sixth sense, pick out things. So I never saw that. But never ever go around and not talk to someone. The Headstrong survey strongly pointed out that any young person, if they have one good adult that they can go and talk to, and surely to God, there's a one good adult for every one of you here in this school, or your parents, or a coach, or somebody close by, a relative, but never, never, never go around feeling that you can't talk to someone, all right? And keep up the great work, and the inclusivity of this school is in abundance, and we're delighted to give you your help promoting schools flag today. Certificate for the college, for St. Dominic's College, on their health promoting skills. And the flag.
At the end of the assembly, we'll have a group photograph. Okay, so if the health committee, health promoting schools committee can remain back. So, and I'd like to welcome Ikra back as a past pupil. Ikra has just completed her first year in Maynooth University, so well done, Ikra, and to Aoife, who's a past pupil but also is working here in St Dominic's. So well done for continuing your support. Words. You're a bit younger than me, so you wouldn't remember me walking to school in the bare feet and carrying the lump of turf from me back and all that. No. Anyway, so hopefully I'll meet you around Castlefin in the months ahead. And in keeping with what Joan has said, as a health promoting school, looking at it in the broadest sense and keeping our students involved in so many extracurricular activities, and that's very, very important that we continue to be involved in extracurricular in areas where we develop our talents that we may not know that we have. So we'd like to honour all those students who've been involved in the various activities, from rugby to music to drama to debating here this morning. Okay, Ms Green, can you call out first?
Okay, Ciara, we're going to invite Ms Daly up to present the awards for the rugby team. We're going to call up Chantelle Dalton, Casey Doyle, Erin Finnegan Byrne, Katie Byrne, Nadine O'Reilly, Tori Kinsella, Sophie Burke, Ellen Purcell, Shauna Rowe, Holly Mullen, Shakira Donoghue, Emma Brown, Abby Lennon, Sophie Ulden, Holly Kavanagh, and Zoe Irvine.
These are certificates for the junior rugby team, all of these girls, and some of them, it's great to see first year students. Some of them that didn't get certs, I just want to say well done to all those first years who've been playing tag rugby at lunchtime. You played the game yesterday, well done, and I hope that you'll keep it up. They were meant to have a game last week, but it got cancelled due to the other school. But we've won, one's already planned for September. I can't go without saying, I just want to say to the 6 years, because the rugby journey actually began with this crew here, who I basically forced to go to Donnybrook one day. And the team has grown huge, you can see from men to girls here. I also have, there's a number of players, they're mostly Turgers, who've actually been travelling out to Burnhall Rugby Club this year. And I have medals that the club gave me to pass on to them. So just while they're up on stage here, Holly Kavanagh, Zoe Irvine, Shauna Rowe, Shakira, Chantelle, Casey, Erin, Katie Byrne, and Sophie Burke. So all of these girls, some of them only played one game at Burnhall. A special mention to Chantelle, Casey Doyle, Erin Finnegan Byrne, who travelled out to Burnhall at the start of the season. Thank you to Emer Woods, who used to bring some of them out. But the last few months, the girls have actually got the 67 or 66 bus out to training and back. And also, I've never seen them so early to school on a Saturday morning where we picked them up to bring them all over Leinster. So watch this space. The future is pretty bright for rugby here. So well done, girls. Yeah.
Okay, so well done to the the students on the rugby team, and we look forward to great success in the coming year, and I look forward to being there on the sideline and helping you. So well done to Miss Daly for a magum. Thank you. Next we move on to basketball. Miss Green.
The basketball coaches, Miss Dunphy and Miss McTighe, to come up to hand out the award for basketball, and then we'll do athletics as well. Just like to keep it very short and sweet, and not to drag on, but we'd just like to say well done to all those who took part in basketball throughout the year. Across the four or five teams we had here, you've been fantastic. We were unlucky in some games, but we did fantastically well in many others. We won some, we lost some, we drew some along the way, but myself and Miss Mateen are so extremely proud of all of you, and hopefully we'll just continue on with great success next year and be better and stronger even then. So we just have four awards to hand out. So the first award is for the basketball team junior player of the year, and it's awarded to Ellen Purcell. So then, the basketball team senior player of the year goes to Montserrat Kadiri. We have two awards for athletics as well, so many girls take part in athletics in school and outside school. And two awards here. The Senior Award for Athletics is Lauren Reardon. We've seen Lauren running the roads many times, doing 10Ks and 5Ks. And the Junior Award for Athletics, she's actually on here today, but it's awarded to Michaela Hunt.
So well done to the first years involved in the Games Club and the students involved with the athletics and basketball. We move on to debating, and these two young ladies in first year, Ella and Leona, if you could come up again. Ella Dalton and Leona Egan, they participated in the UCD Young Women's Debating Competition way back last February. So well done to these young ladies, and hopefully that you'll pursue debating next year, because as we say, public speaking is very important, so continue in your interest in debating. Now we'll move on to choir. Miss O'Rourke? Miss O'Rourke? I think Miss O'Rourke's going to give up rounders. we have a little joke here. It could have been Mrs. Daly.
So we'll have a big gap in the school choir next year. We're losing some of our very talented ladies, but there is some serious talent still left in the choir. And from watching the TY show this year, I spotted some more talent, so watch out, because I'll be pulling you on board next year. Okay, so first up is Shannon O'Connor. Taylor Meehan Murray. Emily Barry, Kira Barry, Montserrat Cleary. Chantel Dalton. Chloe Lawler. Bruna Segura. Anna Maria Lazo. Ekena Ukwani. Neve Byrne. Emma Chisholm-Ukwani. Leah Union. Maya Duffy. Grace Bailey. And Katie Byrne.
It's a wonderful occasion when we have the choir presenting here in St. Dominic's. Now, I'm moving on to our students, and our leadership team, our student leadership team, play a huge role in St. Dominic's every year, helping our first years and second years, and helping all of us in the smooth running of the school. And I'd like to thank you to Ms. O'Brien for coordinating the leadership team and organising it year after year. So I'd like to call on Nikita, our head girl, Nikita Nolan, and our deputy head girl, Leah Ellis, to come up and address you, please.
Good morning, my name is Nikita and I'm head girl.
And my name is Leah and I'm deputy head girl.
As we come to the end of another school year, we must think about all of our successes and difficulties we have along the way. With that in mind, we'd like to offer you some advice.
To the first years, well done on surviving your first year here. We hope you have all made lots of friends and memories. We would advise you all to embrace the opportunities you will encounter over the next 5 years.
To the second year, we'd like to wish you the best of luck heading into Torture. Stay focused and know that your hard work will pay off.
To the 5th years, we hope 6th year treats you well. When reflecting on our 6th year, we think that it is important to mention that as well as working hard, it is vital to look after yourself. Enjoy every moment, because we as 6th years know the year goes by too fast.
To the touring 6th years, as we are coming close to our exams, it is important to stay calm and be confident in ourselves and the work we have done this year. We hope that your results reflect this hard work and that you're very happy with them.
Over our 6 years in St. Dominic's, we have many people to be thankful for. We are grateful for the staff and all their tremendous effort, whether it's Paddy and Evelyn preparing lunches, Michelle and Cathy making the school run smoothly behind the scenes, or Philip, who always makes sure the school is up to scratch.
And to our amazing teachers and support staff, you've been with us since day one, and we have made many great memories together, but we will save those for later. For now, we would like to thank you for making our time in St. Dominic's a memorable and enjoyable one.
You have all given us endless guidance and support that will help us when we leave here. We are the women we are today because of your influence, so let's save all the tears for later and have a great time.
Thank you, ladies, and I'd also like to thank Chloe Powell and Taylor, our head mentor and head prefect, and all the prefects who were involved, and all the 5th years who were mentors this year in their leadership roles. I'd like to call on Ms. O'Brien now to call out the new leadership team for 2018-19.
Okay, just before we go on to the leadership team, buena suerte a las chicas del tercer año y sexto año en los exámenes, ¿vale? Okay, our leaders that we've had this year, their certificates. Our head girl, Nikita Nolan, deputy head girl, Leah Ellis, head mentor, Chloe Powell, head prefect, Taylor Mean Murray. And our sixth year prefects, Niamh Lennon, Holly Ann Monaghan, Donna Tebb, and Alicia Butter. And April Duffy. And also our fifth year mentors this year, a lot of these ladies put a lot of time and effort in helping our first years settle in, and just a huge thank you from the first year team for that. Our first mentor up, Siobhan Lennon, Alana O'Rourke, Sinead Nolan, Megan Doyle, and Sarah Bellamy. Pass them over to our new team for next year. First off, I'm going to say a huge thank you and a big congratulations to the fifth year students under Mr. Breen's guidance as year head who applied to be leaders next year, and no better man to keep you on the straight and narrow next year than Mr. Breen. The four prefects for next year, Alana O'Rourke, Lynn Carey, Megan Doyle, and Sinead Nolan. Thank you.
who assume leadership roles. Very, very important to assume leadership roles and to have the student voice and to have our student council and to have students involved in all our committees and may continue to do so. I'd like to present certificates to our 6 years. Their certificate of graduation for each and every one of our 6 year students to mark and to acknowledge your 6 years. And I know some of you joined us later in our 6 years, but to mark your time here today and your graduation. So we have a certificate for each and every one of our 6 years. So if we could just come row by row, I would give you out your certificates. And thank you for being with us for those years, for your commitment and dedication. For Amina Maga, thank you. Cheryl and Ms. McMahon and Ms. O'Donoghue, please. So, Ms. Keeler, please.
Oh, no, they have some more.
Okay, we're nearly there. We just like to move on. Every year we announce a team of the year, a team who has made a difference in our school, and this year we'd like to announce the junior rugby team as the team of the year in St Dominic's for 2018. So we have the team here now, please, and their certificate to present to you. Ms. Daly. Okay, so we'd like to present Erin, who's the captain of the team. What position do you play, Erin? Scrum half, and this young lady has huge potential, as all of you do, but her commitment to training is really 100%. Herself and Chantelle, I'd say, and Casey, those three ladies, as Miss Daly said, totally committed to it, and may you never ever lose your interest and excitement in playing the game. So well done. So I'd like to present this lovely plaque to you, Erin, okay? Okay, we're back to our class, of 2008, and I'd really say a few words, and we'll have more words later on tonight when we have our lovely mass here in our P Hall with yourselves and with your parents and guardians this evening. It's always a memorable occasion, our graduation mass here in St Dominic's. As I said, these young ladies joined us in 2012 and you've experienced many changes, you've experienced many challenges, but you've always been there and you've always been upbeat in everything that you did. And I'd like to thank you for a lot of your attributes that you've had as young women now, your wit, your sincerity, your honesty, your determination to be the best that you can be in everything that you did, your gratitude, sensitivity, and above all, your sense of humour, because if we can't laugh, it's not worth it. Which was evident yesterday. I think we all went around walking on eggshells. We didn't know what was happening. But the nice, funny, simple pranks that you played on a lot of staff yesterday, I really congratulate you. It was just innocence to the highest, and that's what it's all about. We all got really fun, got a lot of fun with many laughs, and that's what it's all about. So well done, girls. When I went into my office, I saw Miss Green's office first, and well, I won't describe what it was like, but it was difficult to get in the door. But when I went over, they had bean bags all over the office and other items around the room. But again, it was all done in the sense of fun. I think that's what it's all about, you know. So I'm just sorry they didn't put the bean bags in my office years ago. I could have had my little siesta in the afternoons. But maybe I'll leave it for the next principal. What do you think? Yeah, okay. So anyway, thank you, girls, for being you and for your sense of humour. And yesterday afternoon, we finished off our afternoon, your last formal day of school with us, with a game of rounders against the staff. And again, your competitive nature was epitomised out in our field yesterday afternoon. So well done to all of you who were involved in the rounders game. And again, the 6 years and myself, we were the winners. So well done to all of us. Well done. And as I said, Mr. Rourke, better forgotten. I nearly come up proper, but I didn't, thank God. Well done on your yearbook. As I said, a wonderful yearbook, which epitomises all the different trips, the activities, the experiences, and all the laughs that you've had over the years. And I really commend you on your comments as young people. Your photograph with your comment really, really says it all of what you have been involved in and how you have appreciated everything that's been done for you in St. Dominic's. Many, many trips, I'll only mention a few at the moment, the Titanic to Zippet. Last year we went to the Burren, we went to Inishere, and I said, I'm sure Martin O'Gearan was thinking, what are those young ladies when they were reciting Antara Clear out in Inishere? A memorable occasion that will stick with me for a long time. Daniton and Chloe, when we had to go to Rome on an exchange trip to meet young people from three other countries. It was hard work, but we managed to enjoy ourselves, am I right? And also your involvement in debating, in rugby, in choir, and in all areas of the school. Well done to every single one of you. These are memories that you will treasure and I will treasure for the years to come. And when we look back at our transition year and all you were involved in and your transition year, Magic of the Musicals, what a wonderful occasion it was in the P Hall when you again presented and exhibited the wonderful talent that you all had. I go back to the yearbook, I say thank you very much, and I really have to say a big boo of us to Miss Keeler, who's done Trojan work in bringing this wonderful yearbook together. So well, well done to Cheryl. So a boo of us for Cheryl. And also on Miss Keeler, I'd really like to congratulate. Last year we were awarded College for Every Student Award, which recognises the number of students who progress to college and the wonderful work that everybody does in schools. So again, it exhibits the success that we have had as a school, and I'm sure that it will go to strength when you young ladies get your results next August. I'd like to thank our tutors, Ms. Keeler, Ms. Griffin, Ms. McMahon, and other tutors who you've had along the way, Ms. O'Donoghue and Ms. Hart. To Ms. Green and to Sister Liz, who have been your deputy principals over the last 6 years. I know Sister Liz used to say to me when she was here, and I know Ms. Green says the same, she never got to know you because you rarely appeared in her office, so that was great. So well done for that. Okay, bull of us, ladies. As you leave St. Dominic's, as I say here, and I talk to you more tonight, may you have great success and accomplish anything that you choose, and remember there is greatness within you, and remember you can and you will make a difference in this world. Finally, to wish all the third years and everyone best of luck in their house exams, students who are attending third level colleges during the summer, French courses, Irish courses, Spanish courses, people involved with the summer camps with school completion and the local community, and the students who are going to Knockadoon to our annual Knockadoon liturgical festival organised by the Dominican Sisters down in West Cork. So wish you all the best. Lastly, I'd like to wish Miss Foran on her retirement. So a bit of us for Miss Foran. As we say, we wish her many days of sunnis and slantia, of happiness and health in the days ahead and the years ahead. So we wish you all the best, Hazel. And we'd also like to wish Miss Quigley, who's leaving us as well this year as she takes on her new role as a religion inspector with the Department of Education. So I'm sure the religion department would love to see her knocking on our door sometime. So we wish Miss Quigley all the best in her new role. Finally, as I leave you, and I leave all of you, as my role as principal, I know that there's been much speculation as to who will be the new principal. Honestly, I don't know. Interviews will take place in June. Interviews will take place in June, and I want to assure you, and this was a message from the Board of Management yesterday, to assure you and your parents that we will let you know when the person is appointed in June, that you will receive a letter as to who will be your principal in September. Finally, to say, I will miss St Dominic's. There's no two ways about it. I will miss... I can do it. You can do it. So I wish you every success and happiness in the future. Thank you again for the memories, for sharing this incredible, memorable journey over the last 41 years. A journey that I will always cherish, and you've been an inspiration to me. So, Garmagh, thank you.